And but I found that in terms of employment, it cuts both ways. I've had a lot of great opportunities, and I've had occasions. And I suppose the only place where I've had occasion where I think my career was frustrated was at work.
Yeah, and the thing about the chair was that, do you think a matter of being black was the problem, or was more
Well,
particular than that?
sometimes I think so because work. I think I would have been the first person who was black whom they would have had at that level. There have been a number of Asians, but I even to now I don't know if they've appointed any. And certainly the impression I always had from the not the academic so much, but the administrative leadership in the place. Was one of total disrespect. And one had to be psychologically strong, I feel, to withstand that.
So how does that disrespect show then?
Well, in terms of your work, as to what it is, the contribution you have made, not to recognize that. If you say things at meetings which is contrary to what they want, then who on earth are you to say that? And what I had to remind myself is that I had been a senior person at the University of the West Indies in that I was a dean of a faculty. So I understand university administration. I had happened to have to have had comparative experience in different institutions. And I don't think I was arrogant about it in terms of saying, well, I've had that experience already. But basically, I think in retrospect, looking back, I think there is a sense that if your experience is from outside of Britain, then it's not quite the same as if it had been here. I think some of that has changed now, I think. But I think there was a strong sense of that at one time, that if your experience, in a sense, you see, I've had to reconstruct my career almost entirely since coming back here.